What's going on? We are Offended and Unfriended Reacts. I'm JP. We got Jesse and Gene here.
Cheer.
Yeah, we're gonna do another Billy Burr.
The old Billy Badass.
This Burr. One is
Burr.
Arguing about Elvis. I love it already.
I fucking hate Elvis.
Eh.
All right.
I'm all shook up.
The original cultural appropriator?
That is correct. For 2000.
Can we go there?
Alex. R.I.P. Alex.
I guess so. Oh, rest
now,
in peace,
I love
Alex.
Elvis. Okay? He fascinates me. He's like the first rock star with the power of television. They just intersected, and he went to this, he ascended to this level of fame that no one had ever been to before. Hence, he made all the mistakes because there was no one there to help him out. Right? He got a piece of shit manager that stole from him. Bam! He stopped making music, started making shitty movies. He's not a good actor, right? He does that. Married a minor, started doing drugs, got fat, got an entourage, got even fatter, started wearing onesies, doing karate kicks, splitting his fucking pants. Nobody's saying shit. You look good, King. You like that? You like a lot. Royal balls hang out. We love it, King. Keep fucking going. Starts doing pills, gets addicted. He fucking dies alone on a toilet. Right? This man kicked open all of those fucking doors for the rest of us. Right? So I sit down, and I'm watching this documentary as a white dude, which is what I am. I'm looking out my white head, watching this white shit. It's coming back into my white eyes, getting whiter by the fucking second. Right? Now, my wife, on the other hand, she's black, right? Now, I hate saying that because it makes it seem like I'm going to start doing some stupid comparison jokes. You know, those dumb white guy, black guy jokes. And it's always like the white guy's like, oh, Jesus, I gotta do my taxes. Can this chair hold me? The black guy's always like, you need to loosen up. You got to relax, man. You just got to let it happen. Right? It's always the same stupid fucking joke. I hate those jokes, you know, because they're easy. And it's been my experience that it's just not true. You know, 15 years of being with her, there's really no difference. You know, because at the end of the day, it's a woman. All right? It's gonna be the same fights. I don't give a fuck who you're with. Yeah. I'm not gonna lie to you. There might be more head movement and hand gestures with different races of women. Possibly an index finger jabbing at your forehead, whatever the fuck that is. But at the end of the day, it's the same fights. What's going on with us? Do you need to work on this? Why don't we communicate better, right? So she starts watching this shit as a black person, right? And she's seeing all the racism, obviously, that I'm seeing. But she was catching all this subtle shit that I was too white to see. But I knew I was missing it because I just kept hearing her huffing and puffing. Just sitting next to me being like... And I'm just sitting there like, okay, somebody did something. I don't know what just happened, but I don't think that was good. So right when I didn't think it could get any worse, it could get any more uncomfortable between the two of us, this fucking white dude comes on who evidently discovered Elvis. And he's like 190 years old, and he comes out and starts talking. He's just like, well, basically, I was looking for a white boy that could take the down and dirty, nasty blues and combine it with the pristine, angelic sounds of bluegrass. Yeah, that's what he was doing. He was subtly putting black shit down here bluegrass. While he was propping up the white shit. You know, the down and dirty, daddy not sticking around, drug-infested neighborhood blues with the Jesus as white as me, hair the color of the sun, angelic bluegrass playing music, right? So at this point, my wife has like fucking steam coming out of her ears. So I make a judgment call. I just fucking shut it off, right? And she looks at me. She's like, why did you shut that off? Why did you shut it off? I was like, because you're about 3 minutes away from yelling at me like I produced this music. All right? Let's just forget it. We'll watch something else. She's like, no, why can't we just watch the rest of this and then discuss it afterwards? It's like, I don't want to fucking do that. I just want to watch a documentary. I don't have a fucking lecture because of these fucking assholes. I didn't do anything. I'm just sitting here watching TV. Not to mention, we're just gonna get into an argument. She's like, why would we get into an argument? I'm like, ugh. All right, you know why? Because not for nothing, there were some black people in there saying some shit that I didn't agree with, you know? I'm not huffing and puffing. Yeah, I said that. Like a fucking idiot. And she just looks at me, she's like what black people? Like what black people that says what? At that point, it's like you started the luge, right? You can't get off the fucking slip. Now you gotta have the argument. I'm like, ah, fuck, here we go. Guess we're having this. And I'm like, all right. The black guy who brought up leg shaking, saying Elvis took leg shaking from us. It's like, really? Leg shaking? No, nobody thought to fucking do this. Black people came up with that, and you're telling me that? I'll even give you that. Let's say you came up with that, but where did that black dude learn how to do it? Didn't he watch some older black guy do it? But what, because he's the same color? He's not stealing, he's just carrying on the tradition. But if Elvis does it, oh, what the fuck? Now he's the biggest thief ever? That doesn't make any sense to me. She goes, no, you idiot, it's not about the leg shaking, okay? It's about, he appropriated a culture. He took all the music, he got all the money, got all the fame, he's called the king of it now, and he never gave a shit, not even a shout out. And I was like, All right.
Yeah.
Fair enough. You made about 7 or 8 good points there that I can't with you. He appropriated a culture. I get it. You're right. She goes, fine. Thank you. And I go, however, not for nothing, do I get mad at you when you get on a skateboard and you start going down the fucking street? Do I get all offended like, hey, man, that's some white shit. Stop appropriating my culture, man. Some dirty white kid in Santa Monica came up with that, man. So she starts laughing. And I should have stopped there, but I'm a comedian, right? I'm like, oh, I'm getting a laugh. There's got to be a bigger laugh. So keep going, Bill. Let's come with another example. So I'm like, yeah, do I get mad at you when you fly from L.A. to New York in under 6 hours? She just, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't get it.
She just stares at me. She's just like, that was fucked up.
The Wright brothers were white.
Oh, okay.
I'm in. Shoo, that flew over my head, huh?
Oh, man. Well, there you go. See?
Yo, that's
fighting about Elvis.
Funny, man. This one. I can't believe I didn't get that last joke. Thank you for explaining that. The Wright brothers were white.
They were white.
It's, yeah. I was like, I don't get that one. What do you mean?
Gotcha.
That's what I'm saying.
That's fucking funny. He's funny.
Bro, the yes. Down and dirty, nasty.
Daddy's not sticking around, blues.
With this pristine, oh, Jesus is white.
Like me? White like
yeah.
Me.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Bro, Bill Burr is another one. He's just...
JP said it right. He's going to be like... It's going to be Chappelle and Burr. Like, it's going to eventually... If this career keeps going, which it looks like it's not stopping
anytime
soon.
Bill Burr continues on, he's Carlin. You know, like...
He's going to be the new Carlin.
Yeah, he's the new
Carlin. That's what I mean.
He is Carlin.
Nobody can ever replace Carlin, but...
He's today's Carlin.
He's the next Carlin.
The next Carlin.
Yeah, because he does a lot of good subliminal commentary.
And I hope he gets angrier as Carlin did as he got older. You know what I mean?
Like, you know, so
yeah,
but
Carlin in his old age, he was fucking angry, and it was hilarious.
You know what's so funny? So one of my best friends, yeah. She watched one of our reactions about him, and she goes, he seems so cynical and sarcastic about everything. I go, yeah, but in a funny way. She goes, no, I think that's how he is. I go, no, I just think that he's just trying to shorten her. She goes, no, it's him.
I think like, he is. He's just like,
I can feel it.
He's a pissed off guy who grew up outside of Boston.
He's outspoken. I mean, like, he talks about that. You know, he says he's. If you listen to his podcast, he talks about his anger. I mean, just in general. I mean, he always talks about it in specials. All his old specials, he talks about his anger issues. He has literal anger issues.
And she's right.
All it's
right,
not hidden. Fair. It's not hiding.
I think he's fucking hilarious. Yeah.
But what is it? What comes out of the other end of those anger issues is wonderful.
Yeah.
Yes.
So funny.
Regardless, but he's I like pisser. Bill Burr because. He'll and I don't know if it's because his wife is black or whatever, but he kind of brings that. He brings it together because usually white comedians don't do it as often. Andrew Schultz is another one who's kind of bridging the gap of black comedian, white comedian can only say this, black comedian can say this. It's not. It's
well, I've always said a joke is a joke. If it's funny, it's funny. The reason why some people don't stick or they get caught up in the white and black is because the joke they choose to break the bridge is bad.
Wasn't funny.
Right. Yeah.
Right.
Like make it work. Make it work.
Yeah.
Yeah. But Chappelle even said that at his what was it that that inaugural the award he won. He won the
The Mark Twain. Yeah.
Yeah, and he even said, you know, sometimes comedians go up and say something racist, and I'm just thinking he meant that shit because sometimes people don't know how to do it.
Yeah. Yeah.
But Bill Burr, I feel like, and Angie Schultz too. But that's also because they're in the community.
I was gonna say they kind of have a pass. You know what I mean? Bill Burr's is married to a black lady.
And no, but
Andrew Schultz is known because of Charlemagne. Really, I think that's where
he's a very outspoken, black, celebrity.
Charlemagne's like a figurehead. Yeah, you know what I mean,
big time. And he chose. He's the one who got Schultz? Andrew Schultz. Like, he brought him on.
Yeah, that's
people
awesome.
Said he was crazy. Almost like the same, that same, Dr. Dre Eminem kind of vibe. Yeah. People said, you're stupid, you don't know what you're doing. This is some white kid. And
boom. Schultz is now arguably one of the best comics around. Right now. Yeah.
I mean, he's the one who makes me belly laugh.
Yes.
Yeah.
Uncontrollably.
Yeah.
Like, holy shit, I can't believe he said that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So,
I haven't laughed like this in
He could have put thought into it. Like, you see the buildup. I like that. He does that.
All right. Well, thank you for watching. Offended in Front of React. Make sure you like and subscribe.
Subscribe and like.
And watch the podcast.
That's right.